Hi everyone, this is Jyoti. You can call me Joe, and Madhura is with me. You can call her Maddie. And Maddie's going to tell us what we are reacting to today. Apparently, it's something different.
It's something very different. It's not, as you know, we get a lot of requests for music videos, right? So, sometimes it's safe to say 11 out of 10 videos are requests sending us YouTube links of songs we should react to. So this one really stood out because it was a DM I got about an audition video. So they sent me this link to the video, which says the audition that shook the entire world. It is the audition of this young man called Salman Ali, and this was on the 10th season of Indian Idol. So it seems this video, when he went and he auditioned on the show, it really went viral, and everybody was like, oh, you have to, this is somebody to watch out for. And again, Salman Ali is not new to the world of singing and reality TV. I think he was also in Saregama Little Champs, and he was a runner-up on Saregama Little Champs 2011, I think that season. So he's participating. Correct.
So Indian Idol 10, huh? Which year was it? Last year. Okay. So I worked on Indian Idol 2. That was 2006. So is it every year, or it's they've had gaps?
It is every year, but I think there are also gaps in between.
Okay.
Again, I don't follow TV. As you know, I've not had cable TV for many, many years now. So I don't really know that in detail. So yeah, do let us know if you know how many breaks there were in Indian Idol. So this is a video that is posted on Salman Ali's official YouTube channel, and it's got about 12 million views. And again, the person who sent it to me said that this will, I mean, as people who enjoy good music, his singing will really, really impress you guys. So you should react to this. So here we are. So today we are reacting to Salman Ali's audition on Indian Idol 10.
Lovely. Let's do it.
Okay. Shall we?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, play.
Thoughts, the boy can sing. Obviously, he can sing.
Yeah, he was 19 at this time, and then he won the Indian Idol 10.
I don't know. Really, the same season.
I just googled
he won.
It. Yeah, he won.
Okay.
So,
I mean, I'm going to disregard the whole build-up, and I have a lot of thoughts about that. But I'm just going to talk about.
Let's talk about that.
Having either participated in producing content or having seen, like, from a very ringside close view of how content is put together, personally, I don't like playing the violin. You know, like, again, I am not taking away from the contestants and from where they come. And of course,
full respect
a platform
to that.
Like this
yeah.
is also a ticket to a completely different life, not just for the person, but also for their family, right? They can make a much better life for themselves, and they get access to so many things that they actually struggle. But what I do have a problem is to find this angle about every contestant that participates. And it's not just Indian Idol, but it's on any reality show that you watch. There has to be a sob story. I mean, sometimes the contestants can just want to go because they are happy people,
they like
and they want to participate.
And they
like
have
singing,
happy
right?
lives.
Correct. So that is something that at some point almost feels exploitative, because you're playing the violin and you're pulling out all the sob stories, stops to sell that contestant or make that memorable. But again,
sympathy and votes. And
if he had just come in and if he had just sung, it would still be, you know, just as impactful, at least personally for me. But again, I have to say, disclaimer, I do not consume these shows on a daily basis. And I think you, like you said, it also depends on people liking the candidate or the contestants, and it's also based on voting and how many, you know, SMSs they get for that particular contestant. So in which case, I think, yeah, on the flip side, it might make sense to show everything about the contestant so that even the viewers get a sense of how much is at stake for the contestants. But
I think so. Yeah, the adding to that on the same topic, I have worked on Indian Idol as the official radio partner, and it was my project, and we were simulcasting it on radio at the same time that it was aired on TV. So I was basically on the set every week when the shoot was happening, and I've seen it very, very up close and personal. And I mean, Neha Kakkar, now she's a judge, but then she was a contestant. And when she got out in season two, she was crying her heart out backstage and we were all hugging her and consoling her. But the thing is, I've seen how emotionally manipulative these shows are towards the contestants and towards the audiences. So it's a very well-designed sort of format. They do it even in Indian Idol, like the American one and all the others, where they'll pick on the sad emotional part of someone's story, which, like, as a contestant, I wouldn't really want the world to know it. But the contestants are so, like, they're from small gowns and small towns, and not all, but most of them. And then they don't really know any better, no? They have never been in the world of showbiz. Yes. So they are just like following instructions, and they're just like, okay. And then even the songs that are chosen for each singer in the later rounds, and you know, to give the show a more complete flavor, some songs are given to some contestants and the other contestants are not given certain songs that they want to sing. And so the contestants are, over a period of time, as the show goes on, they get very frustrated and they feel like, you know, why didn't they let me sing that song? I'm very good at that, whatever. So anyway, all that aside, like, I've seen the very emotionally manipulative side of a show like this, and I am just very anti, like, just don't have this backstory bit. Just bring them into the audition room, let them sing, let the judges give their comments, and let them make their way out of the room, and just basis what they've presented. You can do the backstories and, you know, who they are and where they come from later on when they're closer to the end. But this is all just very sort of getting the audiences manipulated emotionally, and that whole, like, the more messages we get for votes, our show is going to be popular.
Yeah. So it's also, you're also making money off of the SMSs, right? Because you know, those SMSs that go for contests are not
it's
regular.
Revenue. It's all revenue generation focused. And the thing is, I actually, when the Indian Idol 2 ended, there was a whole celebration party after the finale was shot. And I was having a full on, like, debate with the head of the production company, because him and I became like buddies at the end of it. And I was like, I'm sorry, but how do you sleep at night? Like, I just asked him. I was like, I don't know how you do this to these kids. And, you know, week on week, they're crying and they're hurt and they're emotionally manipulated just so you guys can get more messages and you guys can get more audience and PRPs or whatever it is. Like, I don't know how you do it. But after that, I was so put off by reality shows that I didn't watch any of them until you and I watched Indian Matchmaking. So, like, imagine it put me off for life, you know. So that bit, I have to completely agree with you. Just let us watch the contestants and judge them as audiences on the merit of their singing abilities. And of course, this guy just bases that 1.5-2 minuter that he sang. If you just kept that, anyway, he's going to get all the people messaging in for him. Like, what a brilliant talent. Goosebumps on the first note. What a range. And
true.
Obviously, he went on to win, but I mean, it's not surprising he went on to win. I don't know what the other contestants were like. And yes, it is a ticket. It is somewhat of a ticket. I have to say that also, because, like he said, he bought log successful hue hain. Lekin, like Neha Kakkar, like Nakash Aziz, like
a lot, guys, not everybody gets the number one spot, right?
No,
a lot of
and
times
it's
you
so
also
much struggle. They have struggled for years behind the scene. Antara, Mitra, they've all struggled a lot. I've known them for years and years, and it's about you'll see, like, they've been successful in the last 4 or 5 years, but they've struggled for double that time behind the scenes, mm-hmm. even after they were contestants on Indian Idol. You know, nobody gets a free ticket to mm-hmm. the world of playback singing. Now I think it's much better because now they can make their own contacts.
They can put out their own music
and make their own music
their
with
own,
people
yes.
they're owned with within the industry, like guys who
that
are
is true.
Music directors and
that
composers.
Is true.
They can all just gang up and start their own thing.
Yeah,
out on YouTube. But back in the day, it was very. I'm not. Yeah. So anyway. That all that aside and our personal whatever against these reality shows, this guy has amazing talent.
I really do hope that, you know, winning the Indian Idol opens a lot of doors for him. I really, really hope and pray that he has a lot of opportunities, not just to make a life better for himself, but also his family, since it also shows that he has a lot of mouths to feed and a lot of people to support. So, I mean,
he's just won, no? When was it? Last year?
If he just won, I mean, I don't know how much he's been able to make the most of his first year of Indian Idol, you know, other than the prize money, because, I mean, he's gone into COVID. Okay. Again. One hopes that it works out for him,
and
I completely agree that he's really a brilliant talent, and he has a successful journey.
Yeah, he sang one song in Dabang 3, it says. So
okay,
he's been doing a bit of singing. Sajid, Wajid, Himesh. Okay, so I mean, he's just begun his journey. So. Mm-hmm. Let's wish him success soon.
Let's wish him
and
success.
And let's hope
and,
that he doesn't struggle for years and years and years. Even Arijit struggled for so long. And he worked
That's
as a programmer.
True.
And he worked, you know. And he, you know, there were like countless songs jinke scratch Arijit ne gaya, which were never released in his voice.
Yeah, but again, that's where I also have a different opinion where... You know, that's, you can call it struggle or you can call it hustle, right? I mean, without that struggle, you shouldn't get success, right? You have to work towards it and you have to start somewhere. And I think it's all of those years of being a programmer and being behind scenes and everything is when you finally hit success and you see success, all of that adds up.
It
makes
you kind
of professional. The artist that you are, and it also kind of maybe dictates the way you handle your success, right? So I'm all for hustle. I also think that it kind of builds character, but beyond a certain point, then it also makes you like question of, you know, how many years will you hustle before you hit the big leagues? So
My only thing is, of course, you need to go through the fire to come out a sword, but you also my only thing is these shows are not gonna be that much of a ticket as people are led
probably.
To believe.
That is true.
That's all.
But again, it's also the same case with even the American Idol, right? Every year, American Idol is almost now what? It's been running for a decade and a half or 2 decades. Highly successful show.
Yeah.
Again, very good singers come out of it. But, you know, how many actually go on to become very successful commercial artists, right? So, I think... Winning the contest and commercial success are two very different things. It will open doors. It will get you certain opportunities. But after that, I think everybody's on their own.
Everyone's on their own. Unless you are like assigned by a big manager / label and, you know, they keep helping you produce. Also, the format is very different in the West. They don't have Bollywood playback singing or like playback
Correct.
Singing as a big sort of... anyway, let's not go to it. The Bollywood discussion, but to sum it up, great talent, wish him all the best, mm-hmm. and he's just started his journey, so he's gonna go a long way if he just gets better and better and adds to his skill set over the years, even as he struggles or
yeah
does
yeah.
his time
yeah
So
thank you for that recommendation. If there are any others, do like, comment, subscribe, let us know. We love hearing from you. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Bye.